Hello everyone, Winslow here, your Toronto real estate broker. Today I'm going to discuss immigration and the correlation of Canadians' housing market. As we approach the tail end of the global pandemic, Canada has once again opened its door to 400,000 immigrants last year and a set target of 430,000 for this year and 447,000 for next year. 49% of the new arrivals will settle in Ontario and 35% will choose Toronto as their new home. The vast numbers should not come to a surprise as Canada has the following: a high quality of life, one of the safest countries in the world, thriving diverse economy, top-tier educational institution, and healthcare and social services. That's just a few to name. What does that mean for our local housing market? Putting it in simple form, there is not enough inventory to satisfy demand. In January, new listings were down by 15% with an average day of market of 13 days. Toronto is currently crowded with the most expensive real estate market in the country with an average price of a detached home at $1.88 million. Almost 90% of the luxury condos were sold in Toronto, with the most expensive property exclusively to the downtown core. Some may ask, what's the government doing to intervene? Industry analysts were certain that 25 basis point rate hike is set for March 2nd as a Bank of Canada's meeting. Is that enough to cool down the market? In short, not really. However, the interest will be a narrative of how high and how fast the market will grow. With further guidance on April 13th, with the Bank of Canada release another rate announcement with the monetary policy report. My prediction is a slow and steady with balanced need to control inflation with accounting of global turmoil. In short, I am a long-term believer of Toronto's housing market. This is why I continue to invest, play, and live here. If you're currently looking to buy, sell, invest in Toronto, feel free to reach out and contact me to discuss further.